Welcome everyone to another video, and in this video we found these Zapdos like way after. As you can see, it's like 7:39, and what we're doing here is we are using Raikou and Zapdos with charge beam to duo a Zapdos that also has charge beam. So this is during the Zapdos day. This is like a really late one that we found in the middle of nowhere. And we thought like, okay, let's go out there. Let's do some fun raids, some fun variations. And electric is neutral to Zapdos, even though it says not very effective because flying type is weak to electric, but it's electric typing obviously resists electric as well. And this is kind of a fun raid. Like these are tier 4 stats. Zapdos with tier 5 times, so there's like a pretty big variation. I'm sure you guys would have saw my other video with the 12 unique against Zapdos, and those are just some fun things. And you know, I thought it was fun to see who's really the, you know, quote unquote electric king with the fact that there's Thundershock Zapdos now. The answer is Raikou with Thundershock Wild Charge. Just a spoiler warning there. And you know, thought I'd do something a little different here. There was like lots of ways we could have beaten this. Like we could have used like Smackdown T-Tars and that kind of stuff. But you know, there's like lots of videos already out here. Tell me like another video where someone is using electric against a Zapdos and still beating it. And you'll see here, my Zapdos are just getting fried by these Thunderbolts. So unfortunately, that's not the greatest situation for it. And you can definitely tell there's a pretty big difference in bulk between Raikou and Zapdos. So you'll see here we're plugging away. It's not like a super obvious win, I guess. Like we knew we were gonna win, but it's not like we're crushing this Zapdos. Oh man, Thunderbolt just has a dramatically different amount, mostly because, you know, most of it is because Raikou resists, strictly resists Zapdos. And you'll see here, I actually ran out of max revives, which is fine. Versus Zapdos is neutral, obviously, to Thunderbolt because of what I said earlier. Flying, weak, electric, resists. So you flipped it with like plenty of buffer. I am going to have to lobby twice, unfortunately. You know, then you'll see, you know, some people were asking me, how much better is Raikou than Zapdos with charge beam Thunderbolt before? And I told them, like, it's roughly Thunderbolt and Wild Charge give roughly each an 8% advantage over charge beam and Thunderbolt. Which is why when Zapdos got Thundershock, it was still worse in most scenarios compared to Raikou, about, you know, 3-4% worse. And that's because, you know, Wild Charge is about 8% better than Thunderbolt, even though it's like only 10 more damage. The 10 more damage is quite substantial because it is a 2-bar move. And as well, they pretty much have the same duration. They're pretty much the exact same duration. Which means it does significant more damage. And then even though that 8% difference is there, and Zapdos has a 5% higher, roughly 5% higher attack stat, it still results in Raikou being better. You'll see here, I told Alan just to heal 2 or 3, and you'll see here, we're up with like plenty of time left, so we're not too worried, too fussed about it. And you know, unless, say, I can't recall if Zapdos has Wild Charge. I don't think it does have it in its Pokemon move pool, but certainly needs better moves in order to compete with Raikou. But you know, there's some new contenders coming out. I'm very skeptical if they're gonna be better than Raikou, because they have some very specific movesets. But and as well, like the glassiness of you know, like a Electivire is compared to, and then you'll see here, I'm like, okay, I'm just gonna heal one, might as well be my shiny Zapdos. You'll see I get in and that shiny Zapdos almost gets annihilated. So I'm a little skeptical on these Gen 4 competitors, but we'll see. when they come up with their moves, if they're any good or if they're better than Raikou. But, you know, even if they have Thundershock, Wild Charge, Electivire with a slightly higher attack set, the tankiness still matters because then it'll affect the number of relobbies you do for these challenges. But, you know, something to consider at least. Anyways, I will leave it there. If you guys like this video, obviously give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe. I'm going to be hitting 3,000 subscribers very soon. I'm going to keep pushing out new content. So let me know what else you want to see. And I will see everyone in the next video. Thank you.